What's up YouTube? As you can see, I'm riding this custom made Royal Enfield. Now this is a huge motorcycle and it's nothing much but a Royal Enfield underneath, and that's why you can see the power is kind of laggy, but it's alright. Now this is a mammoth, to be honest. And another thing is that this motorcycle has been created from different parts of different motorcycle brands, so there are several different accessories that is being implemented into this. Now this is a crazy attention seeker, and it is hard to control this motorcycle, to be very honest. As you can see, it actually wobbles like anything, and you should not try to do this things on the road while filtering through traffic. And that's the thing. The sitting posture, as you can see, is very committed. It's kind of lean forward, and you have the center set foot pegs, so it is kind of awkward. And coming to the brakes, so the brakes are not very feedback rich, but that you can expect with this kind of large motorcycle and large and heavy motorcycle, to be honest. Suspension quality is really hard on this motorcycle, and that's all right, because considering this custom motorcycle, you don't take this motorcycle out every day, and that's why it's okay to maintain this kind of suspension and compromising upon some comfort. And the attention you get on this motorcycle is very much justified on the compromise on the comfort. And speaking about the performance that I told is a straightforward Royal Enfield engine. It doesn't offer much performance, but another thing is that it offers quite a bit of vibration. So as I am riding this motorcycle, I can feel like it has a very good amount of vibration whenever I am revving the motor to the red line, and it actually producing a lot of vibration, to be honest. But more or less, it's a very big motorcycle. It's very nice to have this kind of motorcycles in your garage, and so it's like almost a Batmobile in your garage, and you can actually consider this motorcycle as a Batmobile. And I will stop somewhere to show you how this beast actually looks, and you're going to go nuts over it. And this is so beautiful to look at, and this is just a crazy thing. Now the name given to it is Tomahawk Street Rod X, and just look at this machine, man. It looks crazy. Now you have this front forks which are really wide, and the rake angle is so much high that it almost feels like a chopper on the road. And then you have this mean looking headlight in front, so it's like a face, it's like a helmet rather, it just like Transformer movies. Now then you have this mudguard with Street Rod X branding. Now you have the front wheels here. Now another thing is, this is the Royal Enfield engine. Now more or less it's the same as normal classic 350 or Thunderbird 350 engine, but one thing is there, you have a dummy exhaust coming out, so it again merges here. And this bridge actually leads this exhaust, the dual exhaust, to work together. And this is the side panel. Now everything is proper metal and very well built, is very solid. And you have this gloss Tomahawk badging throughout it. Now here is continuous badging that you can see. you have the speedometer here, so it shows the speed, fuel, odo, and nothing much. It is a digital speedometer, and you have this drag like handlebar. It's very low, you need to lean a lot in order to get to the handlebar. Now there is the switch gear. I don't know which from which brand they have taken the switch gear, but yeah, they are very nice. Now coming to this part, so you have this auxiliary lamps here with the crash guard integrated. Then coming to the rear end of this motorcycle, just look at this, how crazy it is. So you have the 255mm rear tire, which is really wide. Just see how much wide it is, see. And you have this LED tail lamp. Now the indicators are also LEDs, so these are also KTM indicators. Now you have this custom build extended swing arm here. So it's a custom built swing arm with open chin, and here is the registration plate with rear disc brake. This is the custom built swing arm that you can see. Now moreover, one thing that I must say, that this actually attracts a hell lot of attention. People just turn around to see what's going on, especially the exhaust note is so much nice. I will also make you hear the exhaust note. That was the exhaust note of this custom Royal Enfield Hyper Cruiser. So I cannot just take my eyes off this custom motorcycle. It's so much beautiful to look at. Another thing is the rear seat. So the rider seat is wide enough. It has this hump which gives you a very good back support, and it's really nice. It's comfortable. It's tad bit hard, but more or less it's comfortable. Just look at the pillion seat. It is also so much accommodating, but one gripe I have is that the pillion won't have anything to hold on other than the rider himself. So that's the thing. Now that was all about the design of this mad machine. Guys, you have watched the video, right? So this is the mad machine. So speaking about the price of this motorcycle, so it's a resale product, so it costs about 3,50,000 rupees on road. I will also attach the number where you can call in order to inquire about this one. So that's the thing. And this is a BS4 Royal Enfield Classic 350 engine, and look at this beauty, man. Everyone is staring at it like crazy. So that's the thing. Hope you like the video, so like, share and subscribe to the channel. This is Ankit Banerjee signing off.